to the grass and got airborne.
Let's watch her here and see what happens. Oh, Kenny Schrader got out of control, got into him. Oh, that's what happened, Mike. His right rear tire came off. Car goes airborne, then when it hits the ground, it digs in and just rips it apart. Let me tell you, the way these cars are inside, he's like he's in a capsule in there. And so
Jimmy Spencer was trying to get around the outside as Jeff Green was spinning and just ran out of racetrack. Just wasn't enough racetrack up there to get by him, and he just clips him.
He'll be coming from the right side of your screen.
It just looks like he was up in the high side, just lost it totally on his own. There was no one near him and behind
him. But this is hard impact on the driver's side right there, man. I think he lucked out though. He hit the right, left front and then snapped it into the left rear. I don't believe the driver's door got a hard lick.
Jump loose. Maybe we'll see
from the back. Here he comes right back here. There you go. Yikes.
Dale Earnhardt Jr. Nate car, the Budweiser car.
June bug.
Roof flaps come up. While this is now happening, Jeremy Mayfield in the 19. He gets tapped.
Yeah, you can see the damage on the rear of his car. He checked up and somebody ran in the back of him and spun him out.
Kurt Busch. There is Junior on the inside, and for the second time today, round he goes.
Same place.
Comes back up in the racetrack. Benson gets by.
And the rookies are in this race.
Oh, Gordon goes around.
He and Dale Jr. may have made contact, and Gordon's going to save it and keep it out of oncoming traffic. Jerry Nadeau also spins.
Caution is out.
And we'll come back to his pit.
Him and Larry Foyt were doing something here. Let's see what happened. Ooh.
Looked like maybe, I know it went behind that pole, like maybe Craven got in the back of Larry Foyt, turned him sideways, and then he came back down across Ricky Craven.
Okay, so many times here, and it seems like it's here more than any place I know of, guys see somebody coming, and they start to get out of their way, and they end up running into each other. You walk in the corner a little too hard on the inside of somebody, get a little arrow loose like that right there, and around they go.
Dale Jarrett, 88, hard outside wall.
Caution, let's see who can get a lap back from Earnhardt Jr.
He's going to let them all. He's going to let every one of them have their lap back.
There goes Rusty, the two car.
Jimmy, he's up behind Spence.
Jimmy just had went by Jamie for position.
Oh, he just got down low. You get down there like that. We saw Todd Bodine do that yesterday in the Busch race. You're in the gas. Your car's a little snug. All of a sudden, the back end snaps out.
Dick Bergeron.
Last week's winner, Dale Jarrett.
This turn two.
I think that yellow car on the inside gets in. Yeah, it gets up into Rusty.
That's Mike Skinner.
Skinner. And here comes the Gordon. He's in the smoke. He had no idea where anybody is. And he gets into to Skinner's car.
You know, Darrell, that's right there in turn two. We've seen that a lot. That's what happened with Dale Jarrett and Steve Park. It's like the car in the bottom just can't stick there and gets into the car up above him.
Larry.
Boy, we got a battle coming back here. Oh. Jimmy Johnson sideways. Oh. Finally got together.
That car missing.
He hadn't given it ready. He's never lifted out of the throttle yet. Jimmy hadn't.
I mean, that was a battle for eighth position, and John Andretti in the 43 just made it by.
Smoking down on the apron there, but
even if he's not putting anything down, Mike, the distraction of a car smoking.
You saw Brett Bodine and Kenny Wallace in the 23 car getting together right off turn two onto the back stretch.
And John Andretti, is he going to drive right through one for the second week in a row? Yes, he is.
Yeah. And he probably gassed it a little too quick and the back end jumped out.
Spencer going after.
Oh, here we go. Trouble on the front.
Jack Sprague in the zero car.
Straighten it up. Keeps it out of harm's way.
Caution is out again.
Now it's going to unfold right here.
Yeah, he just, the left front tire was rubbing on the fender and it wouldn't turn going in the corner.
And there, Bobby Labonte, he may have got tagged from behind, and he gets hit by Kevin Harvick in the 29 as well.
I don't think I've seen a race start here like this in a long time, where everybody's so impatient.
Take.
Normally you know you can't race somebody into that corner. The guy on the outside's the guy that has to lift.
From Kenny Wallace's point of view. Oh.
Looked like Jimmy Spencer in the 7 car got into his left rear. And Jimmy was one of the cars on fresh tires, too. He had just been to pit road about 4 or 5 laps ago. Now, what that'll do for those guys like Dale Jarrett and Rusty Wallace, they will stay out. Who's going to get off?
Here he comes. Here he comes. He's got him this time.
It's going to be a drag race. Wow. They touch. They touch. Craven got him.
Craven got him.
Craven got him.
And Craven. All right. What a finish.
Oh, he just gets loose up off the corner. Coming up off the turn, the car gets loose with him. Blaney tries to get out from behind him and can't. And here comes Dale Jarrett. You cannot stop these race cars. You're going 120 miles an hour. You just got no way of stopping it. And
file an accordioned up here as they come down to turn three. Oh, boy. That started when Todd Bodine got in the back of, was that Kyle Petty ahead of him?
Yeah, it was Kyle Petty in the 45.
And it's just a big accordion. You squeeze it, and this is what happens.
Yeah, and somebody goes and somebody doesn't.
And there's the first contact. Watch Craven. He's trying to get low, but Bodine's already there.
I'd say that
Benson.
It's almost the same thing, I think, that we saw happen to Ryan Newman and Tony Stewart a while ago. I mean, he would just kept coming down, and there was nowhere else for him to go.
He's already gone.
Boy, you Johnny know, Benson was very lucky.
Sprague may have been looking back saying, whoa, here comes that 10 car. I better end him while he was looking back.
Backstretch. Somebody has to give.
Oh,
there it is.
Oh, boy. Somebody's giving. Somebody's taking. Somebody's giving and taking.
And nobody wrecked.
Mark Martin.
They do. Here they go.
I spoke too soon.
Somebody had to wreck in that chain of events.
And they're still spinning here to start finish.
30 car gets his lap back. Turn three. Ryan went up the hill, and then and the old one got up under him. They start off the corner here, and ooh, I think the 11 may. I think he kind of checked up and got run over from the back.
Chain reaction again. We've seen it all day long. Now, Mike and Darrell, this is a box I don't like to be painted in. Kevin Harvick in the 29, Terry Labonte in the 5. It's been about 80 laps since they were to pit road.
See what happened. Left side of your screen, Bobby Labonte, the purple car.
He just gets turned around by his teammate. His teammate, I think, may have given him a little punt there, but the two car checked up in front of him.
Teammate Tony Stewart in that 20 car. That good up there is he's about to lose a position to Robbie.
Oh, Terry Labonte!
Oh, man.
And Robbie Gordon, Brett Bodine, and the accordion squeezes together again. Kyle Petty, Kenny Schrader with damage. Oh, just say half the field.
And they just keep stacking up back there. In fact, Terry Labonte going back up on the racetrack. Brett.
Robbie Gordon is, you know, kind of having a problem with his car. It's not handling all that well.
He's two laps down.
McMurray gets into the back of him, and here we go.
And then McMurray looked like he checked up. That's when Ward Burton in the 22 got to the back of him, and the chain reaction continues.
And here comes more.
Yeah, watch Tony Stewart.
Oh!
Nah, not good.
That's a hard hit.
Not good.
That car.
Yeah. Kyle could have, you know, he had two options there. Try to get down on the apron or run into Joe. He got down on the apron and still run into Joe, but at least Joe kept going. So those two cars just get together and it's the loosest part of the racetrack.
It's a hard lick on the inside
then,
wall.
Man. I'm sure Kyle was all drawn up knowing that here comes Ward. Am I going to make it? Am I going to make it? Ah.
Watch this lick right here, though. Kyle Petty on that outside wall. That's a hard lick.
Yeah.
Now, I want to give a call to our cameraman. When you have accidents that start out with one hit, you follow the first crash, then the next crash, then the next crash. Those fellas are... Is Robbie Gordon outside of Mark Martin?
Oh, Mark just come. The car just spun around. Mark, see, he's already been wrecked, and so his car's not driving as good as it should. And
then everybody's got to come through that days of thunder-like cloud.
Not, they assume there is, because you see all that smoke.
What happened to John Andretti in the 43 checked up, Tony Stewart checked up, Joe Nemechek did not check up. Not as much as those guys did anyhow.
The accordion.
He's got the... Zero car down under him. I don't know. That looked like Steve lost it to me.
Just got loose, bad loose.
Mark Martin and I think that was Sterling Marlin who squeezed through on the outside.
Yeah.
Incident, but I can't tell you something a little bit unusual. Bill Elliott may be gone, but his tires and wheels are on that 38 car of Elliott Sadler. They put a set of scuff tires on. And I don't know if that contributed to the problem, but he did crash hard into that retaining wall.
And a crash on pit road. Ryan Newman picks up the lead for the second time today as Jimmy Spencer pounds the wall. He and Tony Stewart got together, and Terry Labonte comes through. Ricky Rutt, Sterling Marlin, all trying to avoid as the leaders will come around to the caution flag. John Andretti snuck through.
I believe Ward Burton got in the back of the 45 car, Christian Fittipaldi.
Jared got clipped on the right rear. Just get up out of the groove down there. It's hard to tell.
Fittipaldi was around and caught Jarrett, who was going by on the outside.
A lot of damage to that car. Huh? When you hit the wall here, I mean, you hit it a ton. It don't matter where you hit it.
You very seldom see them tow them in on a wrecker. They use a rollback.
They tighten the race car up, make it push a little more.
Bobby Labonte's around on the back, y'all. He just went around off of two.
And in the wall. Caution at lap 251 in the last 25 laps.
Darrell, I believe the 12 car, Ryan Newman, looks like he was out of shape, maybe starting to get loose by himself.
And Newman almost flipped over.
Remember, he had that hard crash at Daytona where he got on his roof in February.
I can't imagine that there wasn't some sort of contact that started that, because that looked so violent. Man, that car was almost over on its top right there. It hit that wall a ton.
Rusty Wallace, his teammate, the two cars involved.
As they come through, watch for the last two cars, which I believe, there's Earnhardt Jr. up high getting through with Schrader and Tony Raines. Jr. and Raines are the last two to get through.
I'm not so sure that Mark Martin in the 12 car didn't make some contact.
Man. Tire went completely over the fence outside the racetrack. Yep.
Did the Jimmy Horton
vibration and fell back to 20th. That's Ward Burton. Genie.
Oh, trouble, guys.
Turn three.
Michael got into somebody going into three over there.
I believe I saw Jeremy Mayfield, the pole sitter there. You see Kyle Petty.
Did all I could do. I got squeezed out. It wasn't my fault.
Behind Junior.
Boy, if he's got, there they go. No,
oh, gonna, Johnson.
I'm just going to say, if he's got to make it without
caution. Come on back to the caution. This is going to be it. Come on, baby.
If the caution comes out, this will be the race right here. If they do throw the caution, indeed. One flag is out.
Keep coming.
No caution. No caution.
Going,
no
caution.
No caution. One lap to go.
I mean, these are guys, we talked about it earlier, desperation, trying to get back up there, stay close to the leader. And this caution was quite a break for Kenny Wallace and Mike Skinner there.
Pretty hard.
Yes, he did. We're under caution for the second time today at Martinsville, Virginia. And there's quite a line. There was quite a line there. So they didn't get all the gas they wanted at the gas pump in time when they made that pit stop.
You saw right there, it just looked like possibly Ryan Newman got in the back of Jeremy Mayfield tonight.
He gets down underneath the 23, gets under him. No. Wasn't the 23, wasn't he involved in that?
It's almost like he checked up because of what was going on between him. It looked like Kurt Busch got in the back of him.
17 car.
Way up high, gets in the loose stuff, back in, comes around, and can't quite.
Almost had it corrected, just not quite.
Him.
There's a lapse for the number 16 of Greg Biffle, turn four.
And you see, Mike, he just got way down too low. He got down on that white line there. And that white line can be pretty slick. I think he got his left side tires down there and just spun the thing out.
No comment.
Goes into the wall. And the pole sitter, Steve Park, ends up spinning out of this and wrecking.
Yeah, they both got together. They come down off that corner right there. The pole sitter actually got into Ryan Newman and forced him up in the wall. Ryan is still trying to get his car fixed. And you can see the
train and go around. Then Jerry Nadeau spins in the smoke. Nobody gets into the wall, but they almost got into each other. Through one of the lead
same thing that happened to him down there on the other end of the speedway. You know, when the 32 spun, he spun the thing out that very same way and didn't hit anything.
What happens here, Darrell?
I just think the 88 gets around. Yeah, he does. He just gets around, backs it up in the fence hard, a lot of smoke. And all of a sudden, he starts down the racetrack, and he has no control. Benson spins and backs up in the fence, and a bunch of other cars in are all trying to check up, and they get involved as well.
Jeremy Mayfield, a 19 car.
That's what hit the back of Jarrett's car so hard was Mayfield. Nemechek spun, but I'm not sure he hit anything.
Years ago that Nadeau driving the 01 car crashed a practice session. The 32-year-old driver from Danbury, Connecticut, sixth in his sixth Winston Cup season, hit the wall at a high speed. Rescue workers had to cut him out of the car.
There he is back there all by himself. Just got it in there. He got it into turn one a little too hot.
Car just came around with him.
We saw that a number of times last night. Same.
Kyle Petty.
I knew Brett was kind of like
a victim
of circumstances.
He tried to turn low to go underneath. He saw Jack Sprague going up the racetrack, but he turned down and just looped around with him.
He comes in view here in a second, buddy. When
don't
he does,
worry about it. That has all the sign. The right front tire went soft, went definitely flat on him. Just definitely. Car went straight into the wall. But he did have a great race car.
As Sadler is the fourth car in line here, and he gets tipped by John Andretti.
Yep, that's what happened. Here comes Tony. Now watch, he's trying to squeeze by, and he gets up in the debris, picks up all that rubber and debris on his tires, and he can't keep him hitting the wall.
From Matt Kenseth.
Oh gosh, 41 car got on the brake, locked the right front up, and slid up in front of him.
Larry Fort and the 14 car got together with Brett Bodine and the 11 car. That was going off into turn one on the front stretch.
Oh. See, the 22 got in the back of the 12.
Harvick gets in the back of his teammate, Jeff Green, in the 30 car. Of course, again, we've talked about it all night. Then the chain reaction breaks out.
Who it is. Oh, there you go. The 42 got into the outside wall. I think Dale Jarrett checked up and got hit from the back. Seen that all night long.
He hit that wall pretty hard on the inside, too. Well, there were three wide in front of him. He had to check up for Casey Mills.
Hey, the 40 car got him again. That's the guy got him the first time over in Las Vegas.
Pace car has picked up the rest of the field.
So we see what happened back there.
Ricky Run has climbed out.
You know what? I think he may have gotten a little tap from the 22 car. We'd have to look at that again.
He's trying to become first place, Joe, for the third time. Whoa, Jack Sprague gets turned by Harvick.
Kenny Wallace goes through the infield. The 23 car, caution is out.
Kenny Donlevy car. Tight pack.
Oh, trouble. That's Mike Wallace in the 01 car.
He got turned.
Caution is out.
Caution's out. Black flag's out for somebody.
That's for Steve Park. I'm on about bet. Steve Park, because that's who he waved it on in the 30 car.
You can see there's just not enough. Jeff's trying to stay down on that white line, and he was sliding up just ever so slightly, and Sterling was not giving him a lot of room.
Boy, Jeff Burt just barely got stopped in the 99. He'll definitely have to get four tires as well.
I think if I'm anywhere near what? Oh, no, I think Dale Jr. was clean on that. I think Jeff's just gotten the back of Ward the way it looks.
There's still three wide coming off turn four.
There's no way to make it.
Stewart made it. Ryan Newman didn't make it. Caution is out.
Bang. There's no, I mean, I knew that wasn't going to work.
Not going to be easy to pass with one lap to go.
Oh, gosh, here we go. More trouble, guys. Tony Stewart up in that.
Elliot Stewart.
Took them all.
Terry Labonte.
Took them all out.
Dale Jarrett.
Junior's in it. Tony Stewart got in it.
And Mark Mops, here he comes.
He came, Mike, you see that opening? He came, tried to shoot in there. He was up in a high line coming through three and four. He saw an opening. They must have told him to pit. He thought he could get it wowed up, and he couldn't.
But I'm going to tell you what, Darrell, that's something you won't see
person like Ricky Rudd, you won't see him make that mistake very often.
Let's listen to the onboard, see if the engine. There goes Junior.
Yeah, I've been coming here for a long time, and they're running a lot closer and higher all the way through 3 and 4 this year than I've ever seen them before.
What I'm amazed how many cars, and he did just look like barely yep. kissed the wall. Is how many.
Takes off with him right there, wiggled a little bit. He gets up there where there's no grip whatsoever. He's coming back down the racetrack, and that's where the problem starts.
They just start stacking up behind him. There you see it going high and going low.
You'll see these guys. Everybody checks up. Looks like the one car checked up first. Four got into him, and here come the rest of them.
Looked like Junior may have got in the back of Skinner as they came around. Let's have a look from Dale Earnhardt Jr.'s on board.
Junior took a little damage, and Jimmy Spencer, a little bump from Jack Sprague.
Yeah, a little bump from Jack Sprague, and around he went, and right there, the race off of pit road.
The adjustments on that.
Whoa, Sterling Marlin sideways on the backstretch, the 40 car, hits the wall hard.
I didn't like the way he and Jeff Gordon, I said it over and over and over again, you can't run side by side.
Caution is out.
Of Greg Biffle, turn 4.
It's all by itself.
Very lucky with all those cars coming at him.
He almost wasn't all by himself. But.
Let's ride.
Gets that little bobble right there. Call that the hospital wobble right there.
And then everything starts happening behind him, and Jack was running well up in the top 10.
Thing I noticed about Jack's car, Larry, it seemed to be really good on the long run and probably a little loose on the get-go there. And it twitched on him. And of course, here these guys all come just piling in on each other. I'm not sure what's going on with the spotter guys today.
Kurt Busch got turned slick.
Yeah, he probably doesn't realize. Well, he's pretty high up out of the groove, but if there's oil over there.
Steve Burns.
Don't even mention me coming to pit road. Hello.
Let's watch from Greg Biffle.
Gets around right there going down into turn one. Could be a nut. Oh, my goodness. Upside down.
Your internet cornered almost 200 miles per hour.
That had to be quite a ride right there. Got to believe something's happened back here. My goodness, boy. Does that not tell you how fast you're going? See all that fire stayed out of the car?
You'll ride with him here.
Uh-oh. That.
Go with Steve parking that car in that same area, hit almost the same place.
Boy, that opening right there, though, that's a hard hit.
Let's show you what happened 1 year ago, just what Larry's talking about.
Yeah, this was at the beginning of the race last year.
Watch how much the guardrail moves now without that dirt behind it.
See Rusty Wallace in the one car get together, and then here comes Dale Jr. pushing Park, and the car goes absolutely berserk and turns over and flies apart.
There were two issues there, as you saw Dale Jr.
He's in the middle right there. Oh, he's in trouble. He's up in the middle. He gets forced up into Ricky.
By Steve Park.
But three wide going in the first turn on the second lap, I don't recommend that.
For a day, nothing race runs. This could be the best that Kevin Harvick has looked in several races in that Goodrich car.
Whoa, Newman!
That is a big time engine explosion right there. Big time.
He needs to get that thing woed up and get out of it. That's oil fire is what that is.
Claire, get it to the bottom.
You see he's still running well over 100 miles per hour with the engine not running.
You can't see.
Right there. That's a fire truck right there.
Boy, great job by the spotter to guide him to safety.
That was a good job.
You can see all the oil running out from under the car. That's what's burning. The inhaling all that smoke and not. Yeah, Park just got in there, got up out of the groove, picked up trash on his tires, spun out. Luckily, he didn't hit anything. You guys right here, Todd, Michael, and Mark have really been racing hard. Todd got, you saw the car wiggle just a little bit. he was trying to keep it down under Michael, and when he corrected, there was nowhere to go but into the fence. Now he goes down here, and the steering's all locked up, probably got the right front tire down.
He gets down under Bill Elliott right here, and I think what happens is he tries to stay off of Bill, and he gets it locked up and spins it around.
Reigns in the 74 car.
As you can see, right, he locked it up right there. He kind of slid it off the course right there, and probably that's where he knocked it either off the rim or cut it down. Cut it down
here, and it's very deceiving. Oh, hear that? Bop, 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 bop. Wheel hop. I knew something had to happen.
And that's caused a lot from a lot of rear brake along with the
thing and take advantage of it.
That was the catbird seat.
Yes, it was. Well, the 38 cars.
Gets into Kyle.
Taking Kyle around. Here comes Tony Stewart. Todd Bodine going by. And then all of a sudden, Kyle.
Oh.
Drove right in front of those guys. Jack Sprague had to check up. Steve Park had nowhere to go.
Yeah.
Caution out. And it is debris all over the track. Rusty Wallace got turned around. And here goes Dale Jr. Cones flying, dust flying.
I heard Rusty say he thought he was having a brake problem. I heard him say he thought he smelled brake fluid, possibly having a brake problem in the front. So that may have added to that problem. Here comes more cars.
Oh, three wide. That can't work.
Won't work. It didn't work.
Silhouette.
There you see Dave Blaney and Bob. Look at them stacking up behind them.
Like I said, big and
ugly. It was synchronized spinning. No caution. No caution.
I give him about a 10. Well, I don't know, 9.5. I give him a 9.5 on that.
Here's what happened. Three abreast.
Just in way too hot. Way too hot.
Yeah. Yeah, he had a lot of help. Man. You see that entrance that Ron took to
he
that
kept
corner?
It out wide, but
that's a road racing entrance. That's yep. The way road racers enter a corner. They make between him and the Christian, they have done some spinning out today. Well, got a little help.
Definitely that motorcycle ride's going to do Kyle good, relieve his frustration from here.
And then,
oh, this is ugly here now. He gets off and, man, this ain't.
He was running in the 11th position right then.
Pie got a little help, it looks like.
Yes, he did. Little nudge in the left rear from.
Tell who that was. Roof flaps are up though, and that kept that car down on the ground.
And there's the pavement we were talking about. Because that was unusual.
And Robbie Gordon, no place to go. He's got his load as best he can, but.
And he gets hit.
Gets hit from Mike Wallace behind.
Now, we saw a little bit of this last night, the Busch race. We had some guys that cut their tires, and tires went down, and we saw some spin outs like that. But fortunately, last night.
He just got up. Well, it's hard to tell. It happened way back, getting in at turn three. I don't know if he got a little bit high and lost the BP or if he got some help. We just kind of saw it. You can see the tire marks went way back. It started on the entry at three, it looks like.
Didn't see him there.
Okay, oh. Benson drives into the 41. But they look like they save it.
Johnny's tire's bent out.
The racetrack, yeah. And eclipse the 18 car.
Okay, that's why he spun so abruptly.
Yeah.
And Johnny made contact with the 41. It looked like it bent the suspension because you could see the tire in the 10 car just turn. Look at that hit. Oh, my goodness.
Seven cars got a bunch of damage also.
Looks like Steve Park in the 30 and maybe Bill Elliott. I saw Elliott spin. Maybe Steve Park as well.
On board with Jimmy Spencer.
He goes in the corner, the leader right behind him, and guess what? Right front tire goes flat. Into the wall he goes. All right, back to the pit road.
Jeff Green.
There we go.
Big car right behind Rusty Wallace, and according to Rusty, got in the back of him coming off the second corner.
One more look.
Hard to tell from that angle. Yeah, the question is, did the 22 hit him before or after he broke loose?
Yeah.
Bottom down there.
Can you see? Oh, yeah, something definitely broke. Oh, yeah, see all the sparks coming out from behind the car before he shot up into Burton. Definitely broke on Kenny Wallace's car.
And then Burton goes up and hits the wall with the left rear and the left front. So that's not good. See them lock up.
The car's like shimmying.
Yeah, it's like...
Remember, he had reported in that he thought he had something wrong with the car. Maybe the left front was down.
It doesn't look like any tires were down, but it certainly, when he got on the brakes, all of a sudden the car got sideways on him.
Something. There's a 43 car.
43's going to get a little help here, I bet.
Yeah, Michael yep. Walter gets in the back of him.
He? Nope. I think contact.
Yeah, I think that's what.
Looked like him and Earnhardt Jr. And I think he got tagged right there. That's what did it. He saved the car after he got bumped by Earnhardt.
Michael couldn't get off.
Michael,
him.
Yeah.
I see. There's where the radiator damage came in. The left front came around and hit with the outside retaining wall.
Ward Burton.
Looks like he got a little tap there once from the 77. Oh, they just checked up in front of him. 43 of Christian Fittipaldi checked up in front of him. Jeff Gordon checked up. But the problem is, when you're that stacked up and you're in that tight of traffic, you can't
pass it along to you. Yeah, that's just too much rear brake in the car right there. Man, that's a scary situation.
Oh, my goodness.
Look at the jack.
Look at the jack, and they're going toward the... And the official just calmly... But look at the damage to the
damage,
right front.
That's from him.
Gordon to the spotter. And
yeah, they got bottled up. Looked like Matt Kenseth and Michael Waltrip were kind of bottled up down there. And 81 jumped on the brakes, and I didn't catch who.
74.
Tony Raines got into him.
See the 77 car, Blaney, very, very high. So obviously something had happened beforehand. And oh, man, this all starts there.
I think Terry got hit in the back to start that. Oh, look at that. Man. All four wheels off the ground.
Up in the air.
And I think this all started from the result of McMurray getting sideways when Robbie Gordon drove on the outside of him going into turn three, and all a bunch of cars checked up.
I'm not so sure that Dave Blaney didn't have a tire go down or something, because he kind of got out of the gas and got up out in that outside lane.
Down here in turn one. Yep, Gordon definitely got booted. And it wasn't like that he was really slowed down at that point either. Getting through the corner pretty good.
Here it comes.
Wow. Look at that.
And that's a slow part of the racetrack.
Yeah, I can't figure that one out.
Steve Park trying to get under Christian in the 30 car. And yep, a little bit of a bump.
You are right.
And Steve Park spun out.
And those big styrofoam blocks, the end.
Another shot. There we see Tony.
Not often you see him crash on the straightaway.
I was just going to say that.
Down in turn one. Going in on the outside. Some contact with Boris Sid. And around goes Jimmy.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Around goes Kenny. So it was the 7 and the 23.
Yep. Goes down the corner and looks like he got that wheel hop going.
Yep, sure did.
And he almost saved it. Just gets the front in the gravel. Just enough that he was unable to. See how it sinks down?
Yeah.
And just sticks there.
Duck.
All right, here we are on board. Looks like he may have had a tire go down to BP. Went up that racetrack pretty quick.
Yeah, went to the corner of the right front tire.
We're and down so, now.
One of our stat guys just told me that he just lost.
Keep going or is it?
Back stretch, tracking down the 45 of Colt Crisp. Look out, red flag will fly. Lathan not upside down.
Kenny Wallace up high. This is racing for 25th place.
And Kurt Busch is going to get into 54 and turn right. him up in front of the 23.
Yep. Look at that.
Wow. And all that fire is coming from Kenny Wallace's car.
Yes. Off the wall, got the marbles there, is what it looked like.
Jumped the cushion, a dirt track phrase. Just couldn't hold on to it.
And then he kind of coming off the wall. Then he turned back. Oh, man.
And him launch that 41 car, didn't it?
Yeah.
Watch him launch that 41 right into the wall.
See that right front,
bang. Oh,
right front
man.
Wheel was is turned to the right, so it looked like he may have bent something in the steering. And that's why he was going back up the racetrack.
Come to pit road, Ryan Newman fakes, Harvick's coming in. Rusty decides to go back out, but Junior's there.
Hmm.
Our left foot brake will always be laying on that throttle, even though he's on
caution.
The
caution is out. Rusty Wallace.
And this looks exactly like Ryan Newman's car in June.
Except the flames not up inside the cockpit.
Not as badly as they were.
A lot of smoke in that car, though.
Rusty wants out.
He's got that net down.
That fire extinguisher is going to go off here in the back. Doesn't look like it.
I mean, that looks exactly like Ryan Newman's car burning the rear of these cars.
Well, that looked like he just checked up because Burton got a little bit loose there. And then it's the typical old accordion effect here at BP. Everybody checked up, and we didn't see the contact on that shot there between Jason Leffler and Greg Biffle, but it was a pretty good hit.
How about Leffler and DeWimmer?
Yeah, that's DeWimmer got Biffle.
Yeah, look at all the cars
down. Hits the wall hard.
Oh, Newman can't hang on to it. And here comes the field.
Man, oh, man.
He's mad.
Don't hit him. Don't hit him.
There you go. Yep, you want to, a lot of times, 9 out of 10 times, you want to go above the crash if you're seeing it from here, because the cars always slide back down the racetrack.
Oh, my goodness gracious. And I see why Michael was so upset. He was upset at himself.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
He caught too much of the apron, and I think, and lost the car.
Yeah, we'll watch him.
Ooh. Oh, three wide.
Oh, Larry Foyt bumped yeah. by Jeff Green. Here we go.
Most of three wide just doesn't work.
Oh, no, we got another car spinning in the back.
Joe Nemechek.
And he gets hit by...
That was Bill Elliott.
And Elliott got Mitchell and Kenseth. And here, Kurt Busch gets in the back of the 41 car, and Tony Stewart gets...
Who's that?
Everybody got hooked with Joe Nemechek.
Joe Nemechek.
I don't know what happened way back there with Bobby.
Now watching
Bobby.
The top right is Christian Fittipaldi.
Ted Musgrave in the 7 car. Looks like he got in the back of Ryan Newman. Got him turned around, and then he got turned around by Jeff Burton.
And then he's going to get turned around by...
Dave Blaney. Blaney. Well, there's format guys to go to the list.
Yeah. And you know, the 12 car, Newman, continues on. I don't think he's got a lot of damage, but these cars do.
Yeah.
Saturday night at Bristol.
It doesn't take a whole lot of contact. That's exactly what happened, BP. Just a little touch like that.
That was for 19th place.
And it looks like, racing. Oh, you're okay, until we come up to that part right there.
A lot of sparks there. Thank goodness the fuel didn't rupture.
Whoa, no, that just got out from under him there. Then he got finished off. Another caution at Bristol. We'll be back. He and Johnny Sauter.
And he tried to turn away from spinning out Johnny Sauter, and guess what?
Mm. He's mad at himself.
Mad at himself, yeah.
The track, back around, down, look at him, he's still chasing it. Joe Nemechek squeaks by and catches a piece of it.
And that's who got him last year, wasn't it?
What happened to bring out the caution flag? Top of the screen. Looked like Johnny Sauter and maybe Bill Elliott got tangled up.
Boy, Mark just got collected.
Sauter came off the wall and just caught Mark in the right rear as he went by, turning head on in the wall.
Uh-oh.
He's going to get some help from Kurt Busch.
Sure did.
In March. Jeff Gordon with his fresh tires.
Oh!
Matt Kenseth in the traffic jam gets Gordon.
Mm. We're going to make contact right here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, 41 thought he was clear, and he wasn't.
Boy, Bobby Labonte slipped through there. Trayer barreled in there.
And Jeff Gordon gets pounded right in the driver's door, but he drove the car in, so obviously he's okay.
Oh,
hits our camera.
Broke the glass on our camera.
Yeah, it looked like the 41 of Casey Mears just thought he was clear, and he pulled up in front of Jeff Gordon. Jeff,
tires are flat.
Got loose and then got hit.
Yes, that's correct.
And then got behind on his steering.
Once these left tires blow out, as he locks up the brakes and just grinds that rubber. Just grinds the rubber. Come on, cue the tires. There's one. Boom. There we go.
Roof flap up there. The car gets turned around backwards.
Still sliding.
Earlier, I thought the hood flew up, and that is exactly what happened. The damage with the hood, they probably didn't have the hood down. The hood flew up, and that's a big surprise when you're running a buck 60 into a corner.
You have no idea that you can turn the steering wheel where the wall is.
Here you see
inside wall.
Yeah, trying to stay off them.
Yep. Tell you what, the exit of turn two is a very difficult exit, especially if you're coming off on the inside of someone.
Oh yeah, Biffle just got loose.
Just lost it. Junior gets by and he nails the gas, does that 360, and somehow gets the wheel going straight. Says, only lost two spots.
I give
pretty
him a 10.
Cool.
10 for that.
This car's still pretty loose. No bite off the corners means rear tires are not gripping.
Now, you know, we saw Matt Kenseth hit the wall at Darlington last week and kind of ruin his car. It never performed after that like it had previously. I don't think Elliott hit anything.
I think he got hit.
He got hit.
In the back.
In the jam up. Right there. Yeah, Johnny Sauer got him.
He caught him in the back hard, didn't he?
Yeah. Yep. One problem about this racetrack with the sealer, although the sealer has been.
You see the damage on the one car where Biffle got in the back of Andretti.
And there's that cloud of smoke we talked about that's hard to see through in the lights.
Richmond, he's on the outside of Jeff Burton.
Whoa.
And Burton tried to go in on the outside of the 38 car of Elliott Sadler. And Tony was three wide. Didn't work too well. There we see the 49 car. The white car comes off the corner. And Casey, a little bit of contact, and around goes Casey.
Well, if he was pushing up toward the wall,
yeah,
and had to get out of the gas.
That's exactly what it was. He was pedaling.
Back off the throttle, and Schrader ran in the back of him.
We're not to halfway. Boy, he got loose way, way, way back there. About when you're jumping on the throttle. Looks like all his tires are, all tires are up.
Oh, keep it off the wall. Good job, Tony.
He had really fallen back.
Yep.
In fact, Dale Jarrett in the 88 car is the driver that got on the inside and banged in the 42 car. And Jeff Gordon somehow, some way drives through that smoke and misses the wall and the 42 car.
Look at all these guys scattered.
Where they charge the system.
Oh, here we go.
Contact. Bobby Gordon into the wall.
Patience ran out. Caution's out. Sorry, BP.
That's all right.
Ooh, that's not where you want to be sitting like that.
Is the second one. He's got to go around Jimmy Johnson. And Jeff tried to.
Whoa! Oh, man. Look at the 48 guys right up on the hood of Jeff Gordon's car.
Must have thought Michael was going farther down pit road.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Oh, man.
And you're sitting there with, I mean, Johnson.
Johnson, the 48 car, got down in the corner and got loose when he corrected it.
And if the 22 car wouldn't have been there, Jimmy Johnson would have spun out.
What happened?
Ooh, he just got way loose getting off of turn two there. Stood on the brakes. Probably flat spot of the tires pretty good.
And look at that. The racetrack complex includes a road course, and that little piece of pavement that he is sliding onto is where you kind of hang a little hook into the infield and then turn right and go outside the oval track to continue racing on the motorcycle course.
Here we see Spencer coming off the fourth corner in the seven, gets loose just like Jimmy Johnson did. He goes up, gets in the side of the 88 car. And the brown truck goes around. He's knocked an oil line off with the fuel pump off the left side. That's where the fire was coming from.
Oh, trouble for Junior. Couldn't hang on to it. Into the wall.
caution's out.
Oh, so.
Somebody just started to come around, like maybe had a flat tire. Was that Mayfield?
That is the left rear tire. We see the tire rolling down the racetrack. That is Jeremy's car.
He's doing what he's doing. He's just mirror driving all over the racetrack.
Uh-oh. Oh, trouble. Elliott Sadler over once and a half and on his roof. Now the car tumbling hard onto the pavement in turn three. Caution is out. A terrible crash.
You okay, man? Can you
hear? Okay, guys, back it down. Back it down. We're not...
Oh, boy. Yeah, I mean, you know, one moves and everybody moves, pretty much.
Right here, and Elliott turns.
Could be.
Yeah, could be.
He could be trying to dodge that A car.
Car flew in the air a long ways before it hit anything.
Now the banking kicks the car back to the left.
It looks like somebody's way up there in the marbles. That's Michael.
Matt Spahn trying to turn off and keep from hitting him.
Yeah.
I don't know. Let's see there. Yep.
That's exactly what happened. Michael got high. He was running that high line, and looks like he got up in the gray area. Car got loose.
And the grass just did not slow Matt Kenseth's car down. But that concrete wall did. Abruptly.
Think he will?
No, I don't
Whoa.
Think so.
Watch out for that. Front end of Blaney's car just took off on him. Elliott.
Let's take a look. Yes, sir. Oh, yeah. That is definitely a blown right front.
See the tire coming apart. That's the right window out of the right door. And you see, well, there's the fuel pump fire. On the Ford, the fuel pump is on the left side.
Yep.
That's the oil pump fire. That's oil that has ruptured a line that's coming back on the exhaust system that is causing that fire.
Either way, it's really hard to breathe inside that car right now.
Gets up a little bit too high. Looked like he got in the loose stuff and around it went.
Yeah, left front was up there. Skinner, he was trying to hang on to the car, and then he bounced off of Skinner.
See the air get under the front of that when he came off the bank.
Yeah, look at it. Woo! Mark did a good job keeping off the wall. Believe me, he was driving that thing right there.
He drove that thing all the way down it, backwards, forwards. He was driving it.
Somehow, I don't know, somehow it looks like the 10 car and the 6 car got together. It looks like the 6 got into the 10's right rear quarter panel. Or Johnny drifted up, I'm not sure, but definitely Johnny got turned.
And hard contact with that outside retaining wall with both the front and the rear.
Half a lap from the restart. Bill Elliott in third behind Ryan Newman and Jerry.
Fast. Oh, trouble, we got trouble. Four.
Elliott Sadler.
Is that Jimmy Johnson?
Mike Skinner.
Mike Skinner.
Sadler tried to go under.
You're all right, digging in clear behind that 24. All clear, nothing hurt.
Yeah, you see him way up high. It looks like he may get, I don't know. He's got the marbles or he just got loose there. But he was, let's ride aboard.
Yeah. Farmer helicopter.
See, there's that big push of air right there. Oh, he just...
Oh, and he's going to catch that wall head on.
Oh, and how did Mark miss him?
Ouch.
Okay, this is, I think, after he's already been in the wall. There's where the right front tire comes apart.
And now Kurt's just trying to get it stopped without hitting anything hard.
Right, yeah.
Man, look at the sparks. That was the
corner, and I turned on it to make the corner, and it wouldn't turn. See, so I just locked the brakes down to try to not hit the 54 car, and And then I feel bad for Rusty. That steering box broke, turning back to the left. It would.
I think 30 car gets into him right here. Yeah. Steve Park.
Yep.
Got to the back of him.
Contact there.
Yeah.
Derek Cope in the 37.
Like I said, these folks come here because they're guaranteed. What's happening?
It's not going to work out.
Like Rusty got a little bit loose getting in, and then Mark finished him off.
See, McMurray got pinched by Hermie Sadler and Jimmy Johnson.
Jimmy was in the wrong place at the wrong time. 23 car gets a little bit loose.
Goes up.
Ooh, the two teammates.
Oh, man.
A lot of contact. Both running in the top 10.
Bill Davis has got to be happy.
Look at the 23 there. He's got a flat going into the corner right there.
He's lucky he didn't back it in the fence that time.
Yeah. Why are we under caution? Top of the screen, Dave Blaney.
Hard to tell if Casey Mears in 41 got in the back of Blaney in the 77 or he just lost it going in the corner.
Joe, rear tire flat. They don't turn real good when you get here at Martinsville to the corner with the left rear. Flat tire.
Gets alongside and around those two cars go. And
look at all that smoke.
And Mark keeps his car going, and that's important. He beats the 16 to the line. Mm-hmm.
1964. Oh. Busy. Oh! Kurt Busch, Rusty Wallace. And no others.
For this restart.
Oh, it looks like Jamie McMurray was trying to get to pit lane, and Ricky Rudd had to just make some evasive action here. That's what it looked like. We'll see. Let's go aboard Jamie McMurray's car.
Oh, and it just happened right in front of him.
Yeah, Harvick had no place to go.
Nice drive job by Joe Nemechek to get down on the apron and avoid Blaney's car. He's racing with Dale Earnhardt Jr.
He just got aero loose right there in front of the 8 car. He slid up in front of the 8 car and the air got off the rear spoiler and turned himself around.
Top of the screen.
Oh yeah.
Close the engine. Slips it on oil. Man. Well, the page didn't get it too bad, but Spencer.
He just got loose. He was on the outside there. Car just broke loose on him.
He and Todd Bodine might have made contact just before they got into the corner.
Like Rusty gets into the back of the 20 car and then 22 car.
Scott Wimmer
gets in the back of Rusty, and then Kevin Harvick's got no place to go. Bobby Labonte has no place to go.
Oh, he and Tony Stewart.
Yeah, he's trying to keep off of Tony Stewart. Turn the wheel hard to the left, and he got loose.
And the inside wall is in. Come on, Derek. Come on down. We got you. Yep, we got you.
I wonder. And Jeff said, you know what? I don't appreciate that.
That's exactly what he said.
That bounce off the wall off turn 4 and into the 24 did some pretty good looking damage to that.
Yeah. Up there got squeezed. Oh, him and his buddy were together over there.
Robbie Gordon. His buddy?
Yeah, you know, they've had a few.
Yeah, he's thinking back to Richmond when they had a little on-track tangle.
Oh, that's right. I remember that.
Greg Biffle. Let's see if he caught the wall.
I think he did.
Boy, if he did, he just skimmed it. Very nice.
And here comes.
Uh-oh, Jamie. This could be trouble.
That's what did the Raider.
So that would be why he would be overheating.
Yeah. Oh.
32.
Ricky Rudd has fresher tires on his car, and he gets bumped from behind.
He gets hit by Vickers. Oh.
Yeah. Tony Stewart and Larry Foyt coming into turn one.
Well, it looks like
Larry.
There.
Yeah, I mean, Larry went in the corner. He slid up the racetrack. Stewart was coming in a lot faster, and he slid up in front of Tony. And
the outside,
yep. Yeah. And he got run into
by
Newman.
Car.
Who was in a hurry to get up from the back of the field.
Yeah, well.
low light right there.
Yeah.
Usually it's when you're going into the corner.
I think we blew it right front. Talk to me when you get a chance, Mike.
Must have run something over. Oh, yeah. That went down straight away.
Yes.
Well, some of the guys told me in the garage here this morning that the
up the racetrack, getting out of four. Look at all the trouble in the corner. Joe Nemechek's around.
Hang on, Joe. Hang on, Turbo. There you go.
Caution's out. Everybody gets by.
Mark get loose. Yep.
Oh yeah.
Mark got loose driving underneath the zero car.
Really loose. And on the right side of the Fords is an oil pump. So what has happened? He's knocked an oil fitting off the oil pump.